हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू द आईटीएस एकेडमी। आवर टुडेज लेक्चर इज ऑन द टॉपिक फूड माइक्रोबायोलॉजी एनालिसिस टेक्निक। बिगनिंग विद द लेक्चर, लेट मी टेल यू माइक्रोबायोलॉजिकल एग्जामिनेशन ऑफ द फूड प्रोडक्ट्स। सो फ्रेंड्स, द डिटेक्शन एंड इन्यूमरेशन ऑफ पैथोजेंस इन द फूड एंड ऑन द सर्फेसिस दैट कम इन कॉन्टैक्ट विद द फूड आर एन इम्पॉर्टेंट कंपोनेंट ऑफ एनी इंटीग्रेटेड प्रोग्राम to ensure the safety of the foods throughout the food supply chain. It is important from the safety point of view as food may act as a vehicle for the transmission of pathogenic microorganism. Therefore, it is important to check the quality of various ingredients used for the preparation of a food product. Here, quality of some food is also related to the number and type of microorganism present in the food. For example, probiotic food products requires a high number of viable bacteria of the specific strain so as to provide claimed health benefit. Very important factor for the quality of minimally processed ready to eat food, dairy products prepared from unpasteurized milk or fruit and vegetables are more likely to have some pathogenic microbes in it. So it is important to check their microbial examination of these products. Traditional methods for detecting foodborne pathogenic bacteria are often time consuming because of the need for the growth of the culture media, followed by the isolation, biochemical and serological identification. And in some cases, it could require some specific characterization also. Now in days, advances in the technology have made detection and identification faster, more sensitive, more specific, and even more convenient than those traditional assays. So it is important to determine the safety and quality of the food, and rapid detection methods are important, particularly in food industry, as they are able to detect the presence of pathogen in the raw and processed foods immediately. So rapid methods are also sensitive enough to detect pathogens that present in low number in the food. Here are some constraints in the food analysis. That is, bacteria are not uniformly distributed in the food. And second is your heterogeneity of the food matrices and presence of indigenous microorganisms. If we talk about, there occur some conventional methods also for the examination of the food for the presence, types and number of the microorganisms and their products is basic to food microbiology. In spite of importance of this, none of the methods is common use permits the determination of exact numbers of the microorganisms present in the food products. So there are four basic methods are employed for determining the microbiological quality of the food. If you talk about, the first one is your standard plate count or aerobic plate plant for viable cells or colony forming units. Next is your dye reduction technique. Dye reduction technique is to estimate number of viable cells that possess the reducing capacity. Third one is your most probable number, MPN. The method is used as a statistical determination of the viable cell. And last one is your direct microscopic count for both viable and non-viable cells. Here I'm taking the first one as your standard plate count. So in this method, food samples are blended and homogenized in an appropriate diluent. This is followed by your serial dilution of the samples and then plating in or onto a suitable agar medium. After that, incubation at the appropriate temperature for a given time is done. And then lastly, the yolk counting of the colonies is done. So here is the first step. After homogenization, your dilution technique starts, in which you have to take your original sample and have to serially dilute it, to taking one sample from the diluent to the next test tube and then again taking the 1 ml of the sample and then again diluting to 1000 times, 10,000 times and so further on. The dilution ratio will be as seen in the figure, 1 is to 10, 1 is to 100, 1 is to 1000, 1 is to 10,000, and so you have to carry on further. So standard plate count, after your serial dilution, the step comes your plating, and you can go for your plating by either for pour plate method or you can go for the split plate method. In pour plate method, appropriate dilution is added to the Petri plate followed by pouring of molten medium. The plate is then swirled so as to mix the agar and diluent followed by the solidification and incubation. When the agar, when your plate is solidified, you have to cover the Petri plate and safely you have to wrap it by a sellotape or your tape required. Then you have to place that plate in your incubator in inverted position for the incubation period. Next is your the spread plate method. In this, appropriate dilution is added on the solidified medium in a Petri plate. The dilution is spread on the surface of the plate using a spreader. Plate is then dried and incubated. Again, you have to dry your plate and inwardly you have to keep it inside the incubator for the incubation. Here the diagram showing your pour plate method as well as your spread plate method. By using L spreader, you can easily spread your dilution on the surface of the medium. After that incubation period, you can go for your colony counting method. In this, number of colonies are counted. Plates having a range of 30 to 300 colonies are used for calculating the result. Plates having more than 300 colonies are considered too numerous to count, TNTC. You can go for the calculation, the colony forming units per ml, that is your CFU per ml is equals to the number of colonies into dilution factor upon volume of the dilution plated. For example, number of colonies were seen were 35, your dilution factor will be 100 and volume of dilution plated is 0.1. Factors affecting your standard plate counting are as follows. It can be affected by your sampling method employed, distribution of the organism in the food sample, nature of the biota, nature of the food material, nutritional adequacy of the plating medium employed, incubation temperature and time used, pH, water activity, oxidation reduction potential of the plating medium, and types of the diluent used. After that, isolation of the pathogen, you can go for the isolation. A specific pathogen can also be isolated using plating technique. For this, specific selective or differential media are used depending on the targeted pathogen. For example, we can use the mannitol salt agar media for isolating the Staphylococcus aureus. You can go for the Salmonella sigilla agar for isolation of the Salmonella. Next is your microbial examination of the surface. The most commonly used method for the surface assessment in the food operation are presented below. That is your swabbing and swab rinse method, your contact plate method, and your agar syringe or go for agar sausage method. In swabbing method, if we talk about, it is the oldest and most widely used method, not only in the food and dairy industries, but also in the hospitals and restaurants too. Two types of swabs can be used. You can take your cotton swab when used, the organism must be dislodged from the fibers, and you can also go for the calcium alginate. When used, the organism are released in the diluent upon dissolution of the alginate by sodium hexametaphosphate. The organism in the diluent are enumerated by a suitable method, such as, again, you have to go for the SPC, that is the standard plate count method, but any of the culture media may be used to test specifically for a given group of organism. In an innovation in the swab rinse method presented by Kohler, you can go for 1.5 ml of fluid is added to a flat surface, then swabbed for 15 seconds over 3 to 2 centimeter area, and volume of about 0.1 to 0.5 ml collected by in microliter pipette. The fluid may surface or pore plate using plate count or selective media. You can take any of the surface for involving your swabbing method as shown in your figure. You can go for the tube swabbing, or you can go for the petri plate swabbing. Next is your technique. Talk about contact plate. The replicate organism direct agar contact method employs special petri plates which was poured with 15 to 16 ml of the appropriate plating medium, resulting in an raising agar surface. When the plate is inverted, the hardened agar makes direct contact with the surface. When surfaces are examined that have been cleaned and certain detergent, it is necessary to include a neutralizer in the medium. But along with this, it has some drawbacks. The covering of the agar surface by spreading colonies and its ineffectiveness for heavily contaminated surface. These can be minimized by using plate with the dried agar surface and by using selective media only. Next is your third one, your agar syringe or agar sausage method. By this method, 100 ml syringe is modified by removing the needle end to create a hollow cylindrical that is filled with agar. A layer of agar is pushed beyond the end of the barrel by means of the plunger and pressed against the surface to be examined, as shown clearly in the figure. The exposed layer is cut off and placed in a petri dish, followed by the incubation and colony enumeration. Beside these three methods, there are occur some other methods also. For example, your direct surface. The direct surface in this method, melted agar is poured onto the surface or utensils to be assessed. Upon hardening, the agar mold is placed in a petri dish and incubated. Successfully used to determine the survival of the Clostridium sporogenes and endospores on the stainless steel surface. Next is your sticky film method. This method consists of pressing sticky film, or you can use the tape, against the surface to be examined, and pressing the exposed side on the agar plate, and has been employed successfully to on a meat surface. Your swabbing or agar slant. The method involves sampling with the cotton swab that are transferred directly to the slant or incubated. Next is your ultrasonic devices. These devices are used to assess the microbiological contamination of the surfaces, but the surfaces to be examined must be small in size and removable so that they can be placed inside a container immersed in diluent. Energy generated makes the release of microorganisms into the diluent, and you can easily able to see some of the colonies in the diluent. Next, last one is your spray gun. It is based on imprisonments of the spray of washing solution against a circumscribed area of the surface and subsequent plating of the washing solution. It was shown to be much more effective than the swab method in removing bacteria from meat surface. Moving towards the next technique, your dye reduction test. The dye reduction tests are used to determine the microbiological quality of the milk. These are indirect tests where the numbers of the microorganisms are not counted as in a standard plate count. Instead, the time required for the reduction of dye, that is your methylene blue or rhesus urine, is taken in account and correlated with the milk quality. So these dyes act as an oxidation reduction indicator and get decolorized due to the consumption of the oxygen and decrease in the oxidation reduction potential of the milk as a result of bacterial growth. So here are generally two dyes are commonly employed in this procedure to estimate the number of viable organisms in a suitable product, that is your methylene blue and rhesus urine. To conduct a dye reduction test properly, prepared supernatant of the food are added to the standard solution of the dye for reduction. From blue to white, for methylene blue it is indicated, and from slate blue to pink or white is indicated for the rhesus urine. The majority of the bacteria, both aerobic and facultative, present in milk indulge in lowering of oxidation reduction potential of the milk to such an extent that dye gets decolorized. Hence, we can conclude that greater the number of viable cells, the shorter is the time taken to reduce the dye. The time taken for dye reduction to occur is inversely proportional to the number of organisms in the sample. Taking your first one is your methylene blue reduction test, that is your MBRT test, also known as. The result of this test is expressed in terms of your time required for the color of methylene blue to disappear at incubation temperature of 37 degrees Celsius. This test renders very useful information on general bacteriological quality of the milk in a short period and requires fewer apparatus only. If we talk about the speed at which the reduction occurs and the blue color disappears, indicates the quality of your milk. Suppose the reduction within 30 minutes is indicated, so it would be considered that it is a very poor milk quality and class 4 milk is to be considered. Next, if your reduction time is between 30 minutes to 2 hours, then it could also be considered as your poor milk quality. If the reduction time is between lie between the 2 to 6 hours, then it could be fairly good quality. And if the reduction time is more than 6 to 8 hours, then it could be considered as a good quality product of the milk. Next is your rhesus urine reduction test. Here dye is irreversibly reduced to rhesus urine, undergoing through a series of color ranging from your blue to lilac to mauvic to purple and then lastly to the pink. Various colors developed in a sequence during the reduction of the dye can be well compared with the standard rhesus urine test with the help of a small apparatus known as rhesus urine comparator. The advantage includes that they are simple methods, rapid, inexpensive, and only viable cell activity can give the good result, can reduce the particular dyes. But along with this, it had some disadvantages also, and these are that not all the organisms reduce the dyes equally, and they are not applicable to food organisms that contain the reductive enzymes unless special steps are employed. Next technique is your most probable number method. Most probable number method is based on the probability of the presence of bacteria in the standard dilution series of the sample inoculum. In this method, dilution of the food samples are prepared as as we were preparing in your standard plate count method. So bacteria within the dilution series are detected by positive growth characters such as gas production or turbidity in the growth medium. So in a most probable number, procedures detect viable organism and is useful when the bacteria are present at low concentration, that is less than 100 per gram in food, milk, water and soil samples. MPN gives only the estimate of the organism while plate count gives direct counts in CFU per ml. So sanitary analysis of the water sample employs the lactose growth medium with Durham tube, a small inverted tube added to the larger tube containing the lactose growth that helps in the detection of gas production by coliform and lactose utilization. And this test is also called the presumptive test for the coliform detection. So as we told you that for this method you have to go for your serial dilution as you are doing for the standard plate count method, and three serial aliquots or dilutions are then planted into 9 to 15 tubes of the appropriate medium for the 3 or 5 tube method. Number of organisms in original samples are determined by the use of standard MPN tables, and the method is statistical in nature, and MPN results are generally higher than as we compare to the your standard plate count result. So it may have some advantages and disadvantages also. As advantages, if we talk about, it is relatively very simple method, and it is specific for in this specific groups of organisms can be determined by the use of appropriate selective and differential medium, and it is the method of choice for determining your fecal coliform disentes. Talking about the disadvantage, as large volume of the glassware is required for this experiment, lack of opportunity to see the morphology of the colonized organism, as in this experiment we could also only can see the your gas production and your turbidity. On this basis only we can define the growth of the bacteria in this method. And yes, lack of precision. Here the diagram shows your Durham tube, showing your most probable technique method for detection of the microbial growth in your product. For this, here we are taking your lactose fermentation broth, that is of pH 6-9, and media is generally composed of beef extract, peptone, lactose, pinolid and distilled water. Last method is your direct microscopic count. The DMC, direct microscopic count of sample, is carried out by examining stained smear of a major volume of sample, for example we can say milk, spread over a known area of glass slide and counting the number of cells or clumps of the cell in a microscopic field. The average number of the cells per microscopic field is determined in 5 to 50 fields, and the total number of bacteria per ml is calculated by multiplying average number of the cells with the microscopic factor according to the formula, that is your total number of bacteria upon ml minus n into mf, where n is your average number of relic per field and your mf is your microscopic factor. Mf value can also be can taken out by as upon am into 1 upon b, where as is your area of the smear, am is your area of microscopic field, and v is the volume of the milk you are using. Thank you for being with us. For more information, please log on to our website www.itlsacademy.com. You can also follow us on Instagram, Facebook, WhatsApp, LinkedIn, Twitter. And yes, do not forget to subscribe our channel ITLS Academy at YouTube.